here in Cologne. Yeah, you already know we here at Dad's Ding. That is what we doing. Yeah, we chilling on the mic. Yeah.
That's Zach.
That was Zach.
Yeah, that's you.
No way. Where did you come from? Where did you go?
Where did you come from? Got no idea. Moin zusammen. Hey guys.
Hello.
Why don't we are our guests? How are you doing?
Good.
Very good.
Very good.
How are you?
I'm wow, fine, it's you. A singing but day.
I'm fine, sorry. Thank you.
Oh. That was good.
And we will play a nice little game. It's called Song Tinder.
Oh, okay.
You know Tinder, you're familiar with
yes,
Tinder?
We're familiar.
That's how we became a band. We all met on Tinder. No.
I will play you some songs. If you like the songs, you swipe to the left, to the green heart. And if you don't like it, you swipe to the right side, to the red X. Yeah. Oh. So let's start with the first song.
Oh man, I'm scared.
Okay, here we go. Let's go.
I think you will know this one.
Oh goodness.
It's one of your mashup songs that you play on stage, and there are only two possibilities: to love this song to the moon and back, or to hate it more than. I don't know, chemistry lessons in school.
I mean,
why are you playing this song with so much enthusiasm? Why do you like it?
I like when Justin Bieber came on and it was like, "Can it be a question?" I was like, so
yeah,
that was pretty cool.
Yep.
Justin Bieber made that song really good.
Yeah.
Like, honestly.
Also, I like the reggaeton beat going.
Oh,
it's really nice.
Yeah.
Always
it just
like
feels
that beat.
Good. You listen to it and you're like, ah, I'm happy.
I want to be on the beach.
And then when we sang it and like we sounded kind of Spanish singing it, we felt really cool. So
yeah,
we
liked
the song
we did that.
Yeah. So let's go to the next song. I hope you like this one.
It's not something I would listen to in my free time.
You don't.
Yeah, it sounds more like Bach. But I can't say that I don't like it.
So like or dislike? Hard or
I like
the
it. I love that.
The dislike?
I would definitely like get ready to that in the morning.
Trap beat in it?
Yeah, basically.
You could put a trap beat in it.
Oh my gosh,
oh,
that would
be
sick. So hard.
Can you play it again? Can you play it again?
Yeah, of course I can play it again.
Oh, here we go.
Yo. Here in Cologne, yeah, you already know we here at Dad's Ding. That is what we doing. Yeah, we chilling on the mic. Yeah, I do it from the dome because I'm chilling every time when I hit it from the dome. Yeah,
nice, perfect, best song in the world.
Oh thank gosh. You.
So,
thank you so much.
Yeah, of course. You can play it tonight, of course.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
We might just
do it. I've chosen this one. It's called High Tea Baroque Music. I found it on YouTube. I choose it because you like tea, of course.
We love
you're
tea.
You're making this very funny videos on your YouTube channel.
Some good
like tea time. You're drinking tea, wearing bathrobes,
yes.
And answering questions from your fans with an English accent.
How do you know about that?
Why?
Yes. Did you do some research?
Yeah, maybe I've seen 15 episodes of Tea Time.
Do you stalk us?
No.
Did you like it? Did you laugh a little bit?
Yeah, I laughed about it. So, but why? What a crazy idea! Why do you do this?
Basically, we just talk like this all the time when we're bored. So we're like, you know, maybe we should make some videos, just going all out with it, you know.
Yes,
correct.
Very true.
You're using the British accent in the videos?
Yes.
Do you think it's possible with a German accent?
Welcome to another episode of Tea Time with Why Don't We.
Why does Jack always explain how you'll get together as a band?
That's how Germans talk?
No.
Sorry!
Okay, no, it's okay, it's okay.
I went for it.
It was nice. Well.
That's nice. Here I... Or say it because I don't know if this is even right. I always say it because I'm the smartest in the band. Does that sound German?
Perfect. Perfect. Outro, tea time.
There's no water in this tea.
Let's continue with the next song. We've talked about German accents, so I think it's a perfect bridge, of course.
Yeah. Okay.
Your hair is perfect.
Sorry, I had a rage real quick.
I have to go it's that way.
You know the guys?
No.
It's Rammstein.
That's a German band,
yeah, it's
right?
Rammstein.
Yeah.
Swiping it away.
I think my dad actually just showed me him. I'm not even kidding.
That's the guy though that like bleeds on stage, right?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Oh, I'm serious. What? I really
he's
know
he's
that.
Bleeding.
He's like an old man.
Everybody is burning on stage.
He's like an old man and he cuts his whole body up before he goes on stage and he's huge here.
They make a very, very special show with burning people all on the stage. Have you any thought about your show in the future?
Yeah,
what
I
you want to do on stage?
Yeah, like if we like all like wow. We're on fire, that wouldn't work.
I think we're gonna keep doing shows the way we do shows,
we
fully clothed and with no wounds.
Dude, I know. We fill the whole place up with water, so it's like an underwater show.
Oh my God!
And then
and you have to bring a tank to survive.
If you don't.
I for the full 75 minutes, you have to hold
the closest breath. Thing to that that's happened on stage with us is Zach fell off the stage the other night.
Okay.
But
okay, that was kind of not literally.
So, but that wasn't planned.
Well,
no.
Okay.
No.
Dislocated
his knee.
I dislocated my knee when I fell, and I couldn't get back up on stage.
Like this bone was over here.
Yeah.
And then this medic person like put it like
yeah,
snapped
medic,
it back in
the
a
medic
place.
Ran back and like
after the show or
no,
during
the
show.
Show.
During
and then
the show.
He came back up on stage and finished the show.
Yeah.
Well, that's very tough.
That's great.
That's very tough.
Thank you.
He's a real man.
Yes,
I mean, I feel like I am.
You are.
I felt really scared because it was only the four of us performing. And we need all five.
Sorry. It's okay. Take your time. It's okay. So let's continue with the next song. Some of you should know this song.
Okay.
Little star, how I love you.
Little star,
maybe the biggest hit of all time.
Whoever is like collabing on this and doing the singing part.
Yeah, the guy who singing the song is in the room right now, of course.
Oh, what's the beats per minute of this? I can't catch a beat.
I printed a photo.
Yeah!
It's so cute. It's so cute.
That was actually
that's Zach.
That was Zach.
Yeah, that's you. No, you know that this is you.
I didn't even realize that was me.
No?
Wow.
it's a video that is, I think, on a fan channel on YouTube, but it's really you performing the song.
Oh my!
Wow!
Whoa! I thought it was just some random kid.
You're a star, a great big shining star.
Sorry.
You don't remember the song or the moment when your mother or your father filmed?
No.
That must have been
not at
really
all.
Little, huh?
Dude, I'm a star.
Yeah.
Look at me.
He goes, look at him.
So cute.
That's the ugliest baby I've ever seen.
I wonder what would happen if I pushed you over when you were that little.
It wouldn't be a video.
Are there any other memories, maybe of your first contact with music, or maybe the first performances in the family? Are there any?
Yes, my dad. He played piano when I was little. And I'd always go to I call my grandpa my pap. So in Seattle, I'd go to my pap's house, and he had like this beautiful grand piano that my dad would always play. And every night before me and my sister went to bed, he'd play us a symphony.
Nice.
And it's called In the Hall of Mountain King. And it goes, dun 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 dun. Yeah, it's very.
Yeah!
Any other memories of your childhood experience or your first performances?
I think the first time I ever heard music, I was in the womb, and I remember kicking to the beat.
She put her headphones up on stomach.
And I was like...
That's so dope.
I heard my mom listening to music when I was in there.
You know which songs? You know which songs she listens?
We Are the Champions.
It was like Cotton Eye Joe or something.
Oh, really?
If it had been really? Cotton Eye Joe, I'd be married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from? Cotton Eye Joe.
Okay, guys, that's a little bit creepy, but listen to the next song. Hey, what would it be like?
Sorry.
Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you go?
You're right, but swipe.
Okay, this song will play in your head now for the next 2 days.
That is our favorite song.
That was amazing.
Some of you said that he is addicted to the song. I think it was a little bit ironic, isn't it?
No, I am very addicted.
Dude.
All of you are addicted.
Yes.
To Cotton Eye Joe.
Yes.
But it was made even before you were born.
Yeah. Well, I was born in 1920, so.
I'm a little bit older,
but I've been taking
like
care
Benjamin
of my skin.
Button? You mean you like Benjamin?
Benjamin
Button.
Button.
Yeah.
Benjamin
yeah
Button. Except I'm more like Benjamin Pin.
Okay.
Huh?
So, are there any guilty pleasure songs that you maybe listen to, but you never would tell your friend that you listen to this song?
Sexy and I Know It.
I got
by Party Rock. Milkshake.
Milkshake brings all the
boys to the yard.
Oh my
That's
God.
A guilty pleasure. It's classic.
No, Yankee Doodle. Yeah.
I don't have to feel guilty about loving that song.
Okay.
How we know?
Like every High School Musical song.
Yeah.
Good call.
Yankee Doodle.
Yankee Doodle.
That song is so good.
The next song for you is this song.
Is this for like a Claritin Clear commercial?
It's interesting that you say that.
My eyes are just...
No, this is definitely a paper.
Advil.
Toilet paper.
Remove your headaches.
It's definitely toilet paper.
It's
Do not take it.
The singer is Bibi. It's Bibi from Bibi's Beauty Palace.
No way!
You already met her.
No way! Oh, what?
We know her.
That's her
you,
song.
You know, you don't know that she's a singer?
No.
She's not a real good song.
That was for a commercial, wasn't it?
Yeah, no, that was her first song.
Is that a newer song?
Yeah. No way.
I think
that was
she made
a commercial.
It after you met, of course, but...
No way.
That's her first song. It's called How It Is.
I didn't know either.
Wap Bop.
What?
Bop, wap, bop.
I like it.
Hey, by the way, congrats on the baby.
Yes, congrats.
Congratulations.
She's pregnant, yes. But you know it. From Instagram, or did she tell you? Or?
Actually, I found out yesterday.
So she came to our show in Canada, but I don't think that she really had like a bump yet, so she didn't even bring it up.
Okay.
And then like a couple months later, we just saw the post. And we were like, oh my gosh. So that
crazy.
Was like our,
that's so
yeah,
cool.
The post is how we saw.
She's going to be
so
a good
nice.
Mom.
Yeah, she is.
She will be a good mom. The song, you know, it sounds like a commercial.
I think she should pitch that song to a commercial because that would be mad exposure.
Oh,
that'd be great exposure.
She would do really well.
Yeah.
She might make millions of dollars.
She needs to buy baby wipes ASAP.
That baby is going to poop everywhere. Oh,
so good luck with the baby. It's nice.
Yeah, good luck with the baby. Okay.
So the next song is this song.
I think so, yeah.
Yes.
Great song.
That's a good song.
That's like,
really?
Don't wanna be an American.
That's Green.
That wasn't that song. Right?
Was that song or no?
Yeah, it's Green Day. It's American Idiot, of course.
It's so good.
Oh, yeah, was it?
You would listen to it.
Oh, wait, yeah, it is that. I'm such an idiot. American Idiot.
Green Day.
It's a very political song, of course. Many people say it's more maybe relevant than ever before. Yeah. What do you think about maybe the standing of America in the world right now, or the image that Europeans or other people around the world have from America?
I think in America, the youth right now has a big voice. And I think as part of the youth and as part of, you know, the future generation, I think it's important for us to, you know, spread a positive influence. There's a lot going on, not even in just America, but in the world right now. And I think everybody needs a little more happiness and a little more peace. So
we want to bring it. Baby.
We want to bring whatever positive influence we can make. We
and
wanna,
a good laugh.
And a good chuckle.
Okay. The next song for you. This one.
Oh, man.
I like this one. Baby
now. Oh, Shape of You, yeah.
No, it's this one.
Thinking out loud.
Going this way.
Okay. Perfect.
Wow. You're like,
Ed Sheeran, of course.
Oh, of course.
And everybody loves Ed Sheeran.
Yeah. Oh, what a guy.
You also.
Oh, we love that guy.
What makes it special to sing an Ed Sheeran song?
I mean, we all grew up looking up to that guy in a lot of different ways. You know, he started just sing, like, he's so genuine in what he does in his songwriting, in his performance, with his looper, and we've all looked up to him since we were
you know, just starting out. And so to do a song with him now was pretty crazy.
Is there anything special you learned from him?
I think it was really inspiring to see. We got to actually hang out with him and Taylor Swift backstage at one of our radio shows back in the U.S. It was at Madison Square Garden. They invited us into their room. And both of them the whole time were asking us how we're doing, how we're liking our first show at Madison Square Garden, never talking about themselves. And I thought that was so cool, how just real and interested in other people they were and stuff, not about themselves at all.
Like,
so
yeah, that was really cool. When you're that big, like, I wonder if it's hard to like so like,
yeah,
you know,
no,
not
they're,
about yourself,
they're at the top of the game. So that was like really inspiring to see.
Will he help you on your album that you will release this
maybe
year?
Maybe.
I mean, he helped us on Trust Fund Baby.
Yeah.
But any other songs from him?
I don't know.
I never know. This is classified information.
We have a vault, and you're trying to break into it.
We do have a vault. The code is 2247.
Oh my God, bro!
We gotta change. We gotta change the code.
Damn.
We should make it longer too.
Good luck, and
thank you
very much for Tinder, for Tindering.
Yeah,
Tindering.
We love Tinder.
Of course.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, bro.